Non-compete agreement. A non-compete agreement is a contract that inhibits or restricts an employee or former employee from being a competitor for a specified period of time. These agreements often go into effect as a condition of employment and become very important once the employment relationship ends, as this is typically when the employer desires to prevent the employee from potential competition. And the employee may want to use the skills or confidential information learned from the employer in order to continue making a living. This is why non-competes are often used in conjunction with non-disclosure agreements. Because if the employer has legitimate trade secrets, these will need to be protected from unauthorized disclosure by former employees. I have reviewed countless non-compete agreements, and unfortunately, a great deal of them run the risk of being unenforceable due to the way they're written. In order for a non-compete to be effective, it should have a specified start and end date. If the restriction is too long, especially in relation to the status of the employee's position, it may not hold up in court. For example, the more that an employee receives in exchange for signing a non-compete, such as pay, rank, and benefits, a longer restriction may be reasonable, which is why you don't want to use a one-size-fits-all non-compete in your business. It should have a clearly defined reason for enacting the agreement, as well as specific actions and information that is being restricted under the agreement. Basically, why should the employee be bound to it? And what is the employee expected not to do? The geographic scope for competition also shouldn't be too large. For example, if your business is mainly limited to Florida, attempting to have the non-compete agreement extend to the entire United States probably won't fly. Have details on how the employee will be compensated for agreeing to the terms, as well as what will occur if the employee breaches or violates the agreement. Finally, the non-compete should not be too extensive and should instead apply to actual and legitimate business interests of the employer. What I mean by this is that you should not attempt to prohibit a former employee from engaging in activities that are outside the scope of your actual business activities or where you have a legitimate stake or interest that would be harmed by unfair competition. These are some of the basic points you'll want in your non-compete agreements, but there are many more terms you'll want to consider depending on the circumstances, as well as a few necessary lawyerly provisions that I won't bore you with now. A non-compete agreement is a great way to protect your business, especially when an employee holds sensitive information. However, for them to be enforceable, you'll need to ensure they are written properly. If you found this video helpful, click on the like button below. Also, to stay up to date with our most recent content, be sure to click on the subscribe button as well. As always, I hope this helps.